Hi everyone, in this video we'll see how to parse Cisco configuration using TEXTFSM module. TEXTFSM is a Python module which can be used for parsing text using templates. These are some of the templates available in NTC templates for parsing networking devices configurations. You can see the commands which it supports. In iOS you can see the list of commands here. So we'll be referring this command, show IP interface brief. When we execute any show command in Cisco device, it gives the output as a single string, and there won't be any structured or way or formatting for that. Using TEXTFSM, you will be able to convert this into a structured way, like list and using list and dictionaries. Now we'll see how to parse a command. For that, first you need to make sure you have TEXTFSM installed. You can just type pip list, and you can see here I already have TEXTFSM. During my NETMIKO installation, it automatically installed TEXTFSM because that was one of the dependency or requirement for NETMIKO to work. So I already have TEXTFSM. Now we need to sync this template to my local machine. For that, I have created a folder here called TEXTFSM git. You can see the folder is empty. Now I'll clone the git to this folder. For that, I'll go to this page, ntc templates, and clone or download. I'll copy the URL. I'll go to that folder, git clone. Yeah, now it will start cloning the NTC templates to my folder. Now you can see there is a file inside TEXTFSM git, and here you can see templates, the list of templates it supports. In Cisco iOS, we'll see show IP interface brief. This file, similar way they have logic for multiple commands. Now we need to export the environment variable into my Python. The command is export net underscore TEXTFSM equal to the templates folder, this folder. I'll execute that in my Python. Yeah, that's all you need to do. Now you'll be able to parse the configuration from Cisco. For that, first we'll copy one of our previous script. I'll use NETMIKO device exception. So I have explained this script in one of the previous video. If you want to know the details of this, you can watch that video. So I already have a file created here, NETMIKO TEXTFSM. I'll paste it here. Here, this script, what it does, I have imported NETMIKO. Then for handling the error like device not reachable, authentication failure and SSH exceptions, I have given some error handling here. Then it configures the device using the 15 underscore config file, and then it saves the config, and in the end it executes show IP interface brief. So we don't need this configuration part. I'll remove that, and I'll give only show IP interface brief command. And here my device list, 15 underscore devices. I have three devices. 3 devices, 12, 10 and 11. So why I gave 3 devices? Because these 2 devices won't be reachable and will be getting the error like device not reachable. To handle that, we can remove one device from this to save the time. First we'll execute it without TEXTFSM, then we'll see with TEXTFSM. Let me check the script before execution. Python 24 NETMIKO TEXTFSM intro. Yeah, it is connecting to the device 10.10. Yeah, I got the output. Yeah, it is a plain single string output. Now we will see how to pass this output into a structured way. For that, since we already have given the environment variable using this command export TEXTFSM, you just need to give a command here. The command is use underscore TEXTFSM equal to true. Save the script. Now we'll try to execute the script again. Yeah, now I got output in a structured way. You can see here there is a list and each interface is shown here as dictionaries, each dictionary. So we'll put it into a notepad and see how it looks. Yeah, you can see the list of interfaces in the router. So everything is having same key value pairs. If you want to print the particular interface properties output index 3. Now we'll see the output. I'll comment this. Yeah, now you can see it printed the properties of loopback 0 because loopback 0 is in index 3. Now if you want to print the total number of interfaces, print length of output. Yeah, you can see the number here, and we'll create this as a variable tab L equal to length of output, then we'll print saying that total number of interfaces are string of L. We'll execute the script again. we are getting the message, the number. Now if we add one more interface in the list, interface blowback 4, now we'll try to execute the script again. Now number has increased. Now if you want to print a particular interface properties with some message, what we can do is we'll create a variable called name here, name equal to outputs the index number which interface you want, Calgi 1, and then the key details, the key details here, okay, any key you can give. I'll give interface, the interface name, then status, I'll give status here, then I'll print saying that interface plus name plus another message, status is plus status, this status. We'll try to execute the script now. You can see if it says interface FS01 status is up. Now if you want to change to another interface, you can just change the index number here. Now we'll execute. And similarly, if interface goes down, the status will change here. The next video, what we'll do, we'll see how to list down the up interfaces, down interfaces separately and monitor it. Here we'll see one more method using itemgetter. Itemgetter is one more method inside operator. So to see the details, you can go to PyDoc operator. You can see the class here, so it just fetches particular keys values. So we'll see some example, the same script. First we need to import the property from operator import getter. Then I'll create a variable here, I'll call that as interface 0, then output index I'll give 1, then get intf equal to item getter, then I'll give the value intf, that is a key of interface name intf. So what it does, it fetches the intf value of each dictionary. Then another is get status equal to chapter, then I'll give the value status. Then now name equal to get intf of interface 0, similar way status equal to get status of interface 0, then we'll print name plus status. Now we'll try to execute the script. Here there is one syntax error. Yeah, we can see the interface status. Just to show how to use itemgetter, I showed this method. Both prints same output. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand basics of how to use TEXTFSM for parsing Cisco configuration. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. In the next video, we'll see how to print the list of devices based on its up and down status.